Hi there, I'm Max and you're watching FutureCool. And today it's about how cool work will be in future if we think just a little different. Everybody's got to work. But is it kind of how we work normal to our human lives? Or is it just normal to the industrial system we are working in? Because they are usually working hours. And these working hours are mostly fixed between something like 9 o'clock in the morning and 1800 in the evening, or even a bit earlier or much later. Are we doing overtime? And this is, well, not a human normal. Because from our point of view, we would work when we are ready for it. And today we have to work when the system is ready. So if the surrounding of us wants us to work. In Denmark, we already have got some algorithms which are just visible for the employee, not the employer. And with these algorithms, I can see if I am ready to work today or for what kind of work. Is it more creative work I'm capable of today, or is it just administrative work I should do? And the system, my personal algorithm, can tell me, hey Max, you better just work 4 hours today because then you're out. And on another day, it just gives me the chance to work 12 hours or 14 hours even without ruining my health. Because we are different every day. And on some days we can work this or we can work that. But it's not the same every day. So we should keep an eye on this. And technology gives us all these new chances. And we should consider something else. It's not just the algorithms for us, which are possible to use, but there are lots of algorithms in the company we work for, in the cities we are, in the region. All our life is, well, recorded by algorithms. So everything which happens in our life will be there as a data in a second life, but not just in like a game second life or like in a virtual reality, but it's our real data. And as soon as we have access to this, we can have some very new ideas of how we're gonna work. Because we have then not just smart cities, not just smart homes, not just smart companies, but smart work as well. Because then we can combine all these data and we will find out that certain works in certain places will be more useful than in others. So even the decision of whether to go for home office or to go to the company or to go to a open workspace situation, or how is it to, yes, find some people somewhere else on the planet to find the solution for your problems. So we can combine all this data and use kind of, well, it's a very new kind of thinking, but you know open source, and open source is not about just producing some content which is free for everyone, but it's usually for producing content which everyone needs, and then on top of it, producing your original content, which is just for you, and you've got all the legal rights on it. But in companies today, we only work for that company, and we try to keep all our knowledge very, yeah, mysterious, very strict ownership. But in future, we will have a certain open source base. And this is very important because we don't have to think every problem twice or thrice or whatever it is. We can just use a basis of knowledge which is given free from everyone and which can even invented by companies collaborating together. It can just be two, but it can as well be 30, 40, even hundreds of companies collaborating in inventing some stuff like a vaccine, probably. So you can invent the basic mRNA technology and then specify your product on this base. So you save a lot of money, enormous amounts of time. And now keep in mind, the first part of that we work when it is best for us, we work in the conditions which are best for us, and we work with the capabilities of which are best for the whole solution. And then it's integrated in all our smart city lives and all our smart homes. So we may even work in holidays. Or we even have some spare time during the weeks, because just like we feel and just like the problem involves, we can work in a better way. And it's not like today where every employer has got this reflex of squeezing out something more and giving the idea of, hey, there's 2-3 extra hours, and then you can get all the figures right on your Excel sheet. It will be more about the value of outcome, because we can measure it. Throughout all the data, we can measure the value of data for the company and for the society, and we can see it. There's even apps out there today which show us if what we do is reasonable for the planet, for the people, for our lives. And this data, you could say, okay, I know it, but you don't. You really don't have the feeling for if you're overstressed, and the data can give you, for example, some very early idea of there might be a burnout coming up, or there might be a change in climate, there might be a change in social health, in crime rates in a city, in whatever. And you're given hints in how to cope with all these problems. So it's not just inventing new products. It's in a continuous collaboration with the data of society. So we get a resonance for what we do, what we want to do, and how we do it. And isn't this a very cool idea of working in the future? So if you feel inspired, just, well, feel free to give me some comments, to send back some information, or to give me some new hints on what we should talk about in FutureCool. I enjoyed having a little time with you and hope to have enriched your life. Stay cool, create future. Thanks a lot.